Ladies and gentlemen, I am the commentator who flaps on that. I am Chip Stackworth, bringing you a special edition of Supernova Pro Extra. We got a hell of a show for you tonight. We got title matches tonight. First off, we have a six-man tag match, starting off with Alex Sever and Akaoni. I forgot these two were a thing. Well, they are a thing, and they've got some company. And if you watch any of our Twitch streams, you would know that they have some opponents tonight. Their opponents are TZ Valentine, Andres Calderon, and a third man. You don't know who Calderon is the man formerly known as Paradox. Gave up the mask as Shadow Star enters the ring as Sever and Oni's third man. But Calderon and TZ Valentine have been pressing on Twitch. They said they are ready to unveil the third man and the name of their foundation, as they say. So, let's see what they got. Let's see what's happening. The lights go out. And ladies and gentlemen, if I'm not mistaken, what if I'm going to have Calderon is former High Class Wrestling Rookie of the Year, Bryce freaking Warren. Been a long time since I've seen this guy's face, and it looks, according to the shirts, looks like the debut of the team known as Killer X. What a very anime name. But yeah, that's Bryce. Bryce Warren got a little facial hair. His hair out a little bit, but yeah, yes indeed, that is Bryce Warren, former High Class Wrestling Super Junior champ. It's been a while. Looks like he's put on a couple pounds, got a little bigger, bulkier. He's out here with Calderon on your left, TZ Valentine on your right. Killer X. All right, we're going to do this. Killer X. Taking on friends in similar face paint. Andres Calderon starting it off with Akaoni. Calderon starting off. Just as quickly as humanly possible. But Akaoni with the counter strike. And Calderon still in a bad neighborhood, by the way. Akaoni tagging in Shadow Star. As they take over the combination. Shadow Star and Oni. Shadow Star up on his feet. Missile dropkick to the back of Calderon. Calderon tried to spring up. Snap suplex. Very nicely done. Oh, Calderon. With the Rana. Or is that a Frankensteiner? Dr. Marksaw's not here. He would tell me the difference. And Calderon. Oh, thought we were going to see some action in Killer X corner. Shadow Star not with it. Whiffs on the Gamagiri. Calderon whiffs on the snap suplex attempt. Countered into a Northern Lights. Oh, corkscrew moonsault. Shadow Star heavily in command. Sweet and sour suplex. And Shadow Star just, he came to kick some ass. Shadow Star now tagging in Alex Sever. Alex Sever and Calderon have had their problems in the past. Calderon donned the mask. I will explain what happened to the mask of Paradox. It's Calderon. Sidesteps the elbow. Did not sidestep. Oh, the snap over Shinlock. Set up. Calderon fighting to his feet. He needs a tag, and he needs a tag badly. Does Andres Calderon. Oh! Pele kick. Thought he was going for the tag. Okay, here we go. And in comes TZ Valentine. One of the guys I really do have my eye on this year. Oh, nice gourd buster from Alex Sever. TZ Valentine, judo flip counter. Oh, ducked the lariat, did not duck the second to TZ Valentine. A Severin company in full on control of this one. Lucha counter by Alex Sever. And another gourd buster variation from Sever. Snap dragon. There's Alex Sever. Oh, Sever ties. Oh, eats a knee there. It's only a matter of time. There it is, the out black. Valentine, though, gets out of it. Back on his feet. Double knees to the face. And just calling for Sever to get up. Sever's up. TZ also up. Springboard moonsault. Now, one of those things I do know about the team of Killer X, athleticism. You've seen Bryce Warren, you know he's an athletic gentleman. As is Calderon. And Valentine as well. All three men in great, wonderful shape. As are their partners. And Sever tags in Oni. Double elbows. And surprise, surprise. Calderon back in. Drop kick on Oni. Mushroom stomp on Oni. In for the elbow. But Oni was already up. And not a front slam by the Demon Kid. He's up top. Went for the moonsault. No water in the pool. Calderon after getting caught. Poison Rana. Calderon almost got the three count. Which we have seen before. Broken up. TZ went for that brain buster. Nothing doing. Nakayami now back on his feet. Oh, Demon missed. Rana driver. Akaoni's in a wild place right now. Going for that Samoan driver. So far, 5 out of 6 men have been in this match. Shining Wizard by TZ Valentine. Going counter for counter with Valentine. They're only getting the better of the exchange in the end. Went for the Demon Knee. No, sir. TZ sidestepped it. However, he gets thrown into the bad neighborhood. Oni. Tossing Sever. And Sever in charge of this one right now. Setting up another Sever ties right to the face. Thought we were going to see another out black. TZ Valentine not playing those games, fighting his way out of the situation. Went for the sweet and sour. No. Thought we were getting a sweet and sour. We got a half Nelson into a neck breaker from TZ Valentine. Keeps surprising me. Max Everett back into the corner. No. TZ Valentine fighting his way out of the bad neighborhood as best he can. Trying to get himself together. Focusing on Akaoni for some reason. Ooh. TZ throwing those hands. Snap suplex on Shadow Star, who's not a leader now. Went for the front slam. Shadow Star not with it at all. Shadow Star going up top. You know what this usually means. Here comes Shadow Star press. And Shadow Star getting the W. It's Killer X not looking good in their official televised debut. Calderon doing his best. Bryce Warren not at all in this match. That's queer. That's a little odd. After a couple years off, Bryce Warren did not even get as much as a tag. For a while, it became a 3-on-2 handicap match. Killer Instinct, though. What a maneuver. There's a Shining Wizard from TZ Valentine. But you can only fight off people for so long before it catches up to you. I do not think this is the end. For any of these men. I got a question. What the hell Bryce Warren was doing if he wasn't here to wrestle? It's a good one-on-one matchup right here. Vic Torrey said he could beat anybody at any time. Monterey Black, his agent, basically backed up that claim. Jeff Powell, our current Supernova Pro World Heavyweight Champion, said, "I ain't got nothing better to do." Well, he didn't say it in those kind of words, but he said he was more than up to the challenge of victory. Since he wants to, since the young kid wants to run his mouth, he's going to shut it. And that led to this. Victory. The main event. One-on-one tonight. Or today. It's actually kind of early here. We just got set up after watching an amazing episode of Blitz Remedy, was just chock full of ladies. There were so many ladies there. I mean, man, I sound like a creepy dude right now, like so many women. But the ladies of the triad were on display today, and it was wonderful to see. If you haven't gotten a chance to see it, please, after the show, of course, go back, watch Blitz Remedy. I went to school with somebody named Blitz Remedy. Anyway, there we go. Victory, main event. That match is happening now. Boogie, 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 boogie. I don't know why I just did that. Chippy Stocks is losing it. And out comes Victory. Looked good in his debut. I'm really impressed with this kid so far. I really am. And with Monterey Black as his agent, who knows how far he can go? He has the walk of a champion. He has the swagger of a champion. He has an impressive skill set. When you're in the know, with the likes of Trustin Banks, you do have a pedigree. Look at the fans. Victory has gained a fan base already. I don't know if you've seen. You gotta catch these Twitch specials, man. The kid's all right. The kid had earned himself a following. Supernova Pro Wrestling's World Heavyweight Champion comes out. Few years back was shunned, pretty much blackballed from high class wrestling, and now stands in front of you, a Supernova Pro's World Heavyweight Champion, after pretty much retraining and retooling himself, humbling himself. Pretty much overall becoming a better person and a better wrestler. Great guy. Nice mentor, nice back locker room leader he has become. And now he is our current Supernova Pro World Heavyweight Champion. This match, Victory, the main event. This one is a go. Running tornado DDT by Victory, showing that he is taking this match very seriously, and he knows who he's up against. Went for the knee strike. Oh, and Jeff Powell just with the sickest clothesline I've seen in a long while. Victory, another float over DDT. Kid's got agility, I know that much. It's taken down. The main event, main event, main event. I don't know what he's thinking right now. Ooh! Low hanging flatliner, swing low. Vic Torrey back on his feet. Quick jawbreaker and a forearm counter. Pause there, that's forearm right here. Oh, chop, chop, chop. Judo flip. Kinda. Pillar to post, coast to coast. Victoria having none of his nonsense. Jeff Powell having none of Victoria's nonsense. Oh! I don't even know what to call that. But Jeff Powell consistently throwing new tricks out. And a float over DDT for good measure. Take that, Vic. I got one as well. Powell with the knee to the right across the forehead. Right across his forehead. So nice, he's gonna do it twice. Suck on that. How's it taste? Joy says it tastes terrible. Sweeps the leg, Cobra Kai. By the way, if you haven't seen Cobra Kai, you really need to. 8 Shades of Dope. Cheap plug. Victory. Springboard front drop kick. And Captain Sparkles only gets a one count on the world champ. But he's going for what he knows. And a sick clothesline. The main event has been having some issues. Oh, spine buster. Floats over into the pin. 1.5 from the main event. Well, the main event is pumped. Well, if you see him, the spine buster, you know what's coming. Skyliner! He never pins. And Jeff Powell, world champ. After a nice effort, great effort by Victoria. I hold nothing against Victoria in this one. He came to go. The kid talked a big game, backed it all up. But Captain Sparkles became the victim of that sick spine buster. There's another look at it. Oh, call the ambulance, come pick up your people. Only a two count. Victory gets up. That wasn't a Skyliner. And that was it, folks. The Skyliner doing the job for the main event. Our Supernova Pro World Heavyweight Champion. And the redemption story continues. The winner is Monterey Black, just out there, just yip-yapping at the fans. The fans are in styles. But there's not enough yip-yapping that can stop the fact that Victory caught an L to the world champ. But it was also a very good match. So there's that. Let's not act like it wasn't. Ho, ho, ho. Speaking of ladies, we have an extreme three-way match happening tonight as our champion, Wildcat Wiley, takes on Vanessa Delphine and Stephanie Basic, who looked really good against Shannon Higgins in her debut match. I don't know why she... Okay, I know why. I know why she's in this match. Shannon Higgins was over. She went home. The Blitz Wrestling Organization had one hell of a match tonight. Or earlier today. Sorry. Couldn't be here. Stephanie Basic said, hey, any opportunity to get an opportunity, I'm taking. So here we go. Triple threat. BJ Wiley, Vanessa Delphine, and Stephanie Basic. I just read from right to left like Japanese manga. As if there are any kind of manga. Is there Russian manga? I would love to see Russian manga. It's probably dope as hell. I'm just saying what I want because I know nobody's here. But this is a rare special attraction. And I can't wait to see these ladies go. SP Dub Arena. Packed to the brim, as usual. And it's time to level up. Mighty Number 5 is here. Representing Scotland. I don't know if that's a Scottish accent. I should stop trying to make accents. But Vanessa Delphine, always ready to give it her best go. Let's enter the ring. Looking fantastic. Very strong. One of my favorite wrestlers, I gotta say, in the entire tournament. One of my faves. Very consistent performer. Very fun to watch in the ring. She awaits her opponents because Vanessa Delphine was first. So triple threats go. One person has to go first. Next person comes out, and it's Stephanie Basic. Shiny for no reason. Just no reason to be that shiny. You know what she needs? A $900,000 code. I gotta get. I gotta get Valentina's people on that. See if we can get her a $900,000 code. See if we can get on the low. Maybe Skeevy Ray will pay. You know what? I'm trailing off. Vanessa Delphine is already in there. Yeah. Stephanie Basic. Impressive in her debut match against Shannon Higgins. Like, incredibly impressive. And in her second match in Supernova Pro, decides to get into a triple threat hardcore match featuring our champ and folks. It is time to get into the Wildcat formation. Haha! Thought I wasn't going to say it, but I did. Here's our champ, DJ Wiley. Been champ since unrestricted, if I'm not mistaken. Has been untouchable, just about. Till earlier this week. Took on Breeze, newest member of Project Mayhem. Caught the L to the Cortador Trenzado. Dr. Martel. That's what you call it. But BJ Wiley, still our champ. Might not be after Scars and Stripes. We'll see what the future holds. Delphine, Basic, Wiley. This triple threat is a go. Good luck, Dash. Wizard special by Stephanie Basic right up the top. DJ Wiley just violates Wizard rule. A lot of wizardry going on at the beginning of this match. Brought Stephanie Basic in the hard way, did DJ Wiley. Watch out!
kick to the lower back. Stephanie Basic trying to show toughness. Got back up on her feet. Got held there in that headlock for a moment. DJ Wiley. Drop kick. Overhead belly to belly suplex. Rear chin lock as Stephanie Basic tries to figure out her life right now. Wondering if she should go back to college. Get herself a degree. Oh, nope, she's back. Vanessa Delphine, no sliz out. Float over DDT. And DJ now rolling to the outside, trying to figure her life out. A suplex backbreaker from Vanessa Delphine. What is happening right here, right now? Oh, I thought she was going to go with that patented dropkick, but she's only done it once in Supernova Pro. Now we're chasing each other in and out of the ring. That's what you get for running. Oh, Delphine wiggles out of the suplex. Hits a suplex of her own on the chin. Nice reverse DDT and then a knee to the face. Vanessa Delphine on fire. Sorta kind of pissed the champ off. Sorta kind of doesn't care that she pissed the champ off. That's Delphine. Running bulldog. And then, I want to say it's a discus Larry. It might have been a discus Polish hammer. And Delphine just acting all kinds of crazy right now. Next one with suplex. DJ Wiley on the comeback. Disrespectful slap. Stephanie Basic. Whew, that overhead slam. Stephanie Basic. What's she thinking now? Hurricanrana. Off the middle rope. That's Delphine, however. Springboard. Body splash. But this would be a very hardcore match under hardcore rules. There have been zero weapons used. Double DDT. Short-lived. And springboard blockbuster. Bipolar coaster, if you will, sends Vanessa to the outside. And no ritual, just right into the driver of Black Chaos. The cover. Almost got the three count. Delphine, last minute, breaks up the pin. But BJ still in control of this match. Went to dive on Delphine. Delphine moves, still gets Basic. A nice corner attack by BJ Wiley. Only gets a one count off of Delphine, however. Delphine in it to win it. Suplex backbreaker combo. Nice stalling vertical. Basic still on her feet. Oh, whipping neck breaker by Basic out of nowhere. Chaos Ritual. Oh, Basic fighting Wiley off. We knew what was coming. And Stephanie Basic. Avoids the same fate as Vanessa Delphine, who is probably dead. Sliding drive by dropkick. No, Vanessa Delphine is okay. Basic only gets a one count. Speedy Wiley back on the feet. Jawbreaker counter. Reversal? Counter. Bunch of counters. Overhead belly to belly. PJ's on fire. Two count on Delphine. This has actually been a very impressive match between these three ladies. Not a one single weapon. Another two count. Dash coming. Violates Wizard Rule. Gets lucky. Oh, forearm exchange. Stephanie Basic, whipping neck breaker. And Stephanie Basic gets the W for the second show in a row. Our champ has been pinned. There's the driver, Black Chaos. Black Chaos Ritual. The champ looked great. Not gonna lie, champ looked pretty awesome. Stephanie Basic in her second match, impressing. Overhead belly to belly suplex. In the end, Stephanie Basic beats two of the most talented women in the triad. Standing tall at 5'3". Yeah, Stephanie Basic gets the win. We move on. That's all I can say about it. I'm kind of stunned. I'm not even going to lie. And this one has just been brewing, and I think Travis Palmer is asking for problems. International Championship on the line. Special stipulation, since we are over the borderline in Niagara Falls. International Championship can be defended. Ace Stevens said, Ace Stevens has become so confident because he's beaten Travis Palmer twice in a row. First time in embarrassing fashion. Second time in a way more competitive match. He just wants to silence Travis Palmer once and for all, puts the championship on the line. Travis Palmer quickly accepted. So we get a special international championship match between Travis Palmer and Ace Stevens. Which I'm perfectly okay with. I'm 100% okay with this match. And you should too. ACW Championship Announcer Logo here with us. By the way, shout out to High Class Wrestling. Due to some scheduling conflicts and with their announcer B.I. Double being under the weather, There was no high class wrestling this week. It's okay though. The Triad picked up the slack. You got 2 episodes of Blitz. You got 2 episodes of Supernova Pro. And that is plenty until they can come back next week. Speedy recovery to BI double. And Project Mayhem is here. As Travis Palmer saunters down to the ring. Looking pretty awesome. He's had a pretty solid year. Then went to the church of Ripley. Went to the altar of Ripley. Got himself refocused. Now he's here to kick some ass. Hasn't quite figured out Ace Stevens yet. Ace Stevens so confident. He put the title on the line. There he is. This one's pretty interesting. Because sometimes it's just overconfidence that gets you. And pride comes before the fall. And out comes Mr. International. Ace Stevens. Surprise. One of this season's biggest surprises. Ace Stevens. Defeating the Iceman and Unrestricted 2 Electric Boogaloo for the International Championship. I'm sorry, it wasn't Unrestricted 2. I'm sorry, it was International Incident. Because it's an international pay-per-view. And that's the international title, and those are the rules of the International Championship. It can only be defended outside of U.S. soil. Okay. Now back to this point. We got the International Championship on the line. And Lolo, fine-ass high-class ring announcer. The challenger, 241 pounds. Manchester, England. The brutal Brit, Travis Palmer. And the champ. Louisville, Kentucky. We actually just did a show there. The international champion, 212 pounds. Ace Stevens. Got a huge pop in Louisville. Did Mr. International. One of the few places he does get a pop. As he hands the belt over to Dash Cunning. Dash Cunning shows it to Travis Palmer. Throws it up in the air. Palmer. Stevens. International championship is a go. Oh, I thought it was a collar and elbow tie-up. Nope. Ace Stevens just raking. First the face, then the back. Ace Stevens dominating the hell out of Travis Palmer. Travis Palmer, no slizz ouch. Roll up. There it is. Air raid neck breaker. Travis Palmer does have an impressive moveset. Just can't put it together against Ace Stevens. Kick to the face, however, from Travis Palmer. Neck breaker. Now Travis Palmer is doing all the dominating. And Stevens finds his way back up to his feet. Diamond's carry to the counter. Here we go. There's another knee. And then another neck breaker from the brutal Brit. Oh, you're going to lose the fist game, Travis Palmer. You're going to lose the strength game, Ace Stevens. Kick out reverse DDT from Travis Palmer, stopping all the countering. There's those knees. Triple threat knee strike. Made famous by Jeff Powell and Steve Taylor. went for the senton. Ace Stevens got the knees up. Then went to charge Travis Palmer. Travis Palmer threw him outside the ring, and we're in the playground, folks. Be mindful of the... Oh, no, there is no count. I forgot. This is a championship match. There's no count. This is false count anywhere. Triple threat knee strike. I'm being handed a note. There's also a 2 out of 3 falls match, so, you know, do with that information what you will. Jay Stevens trying to get control back into this match. Eats barricade and a Palmer strike. Probably, honestly, it's probably my favorite move. It's just such a disrespectful palm to the face. Jay Stevens fighting back. Dash Cunning comes from across the street. There was no count because Dash Cunning has no idea how to get in position outside of the ring. And Ace Stevens throwing him fist assists. Travis Palmer getting this match back into his favor. Sit out powerbomb. We got a one count. Yes, Travis, a one count. Palmer Vice. Travis Palmer gets the first fall. This was a regular match. It would already be over. Up. Cutting and strutting from Ace Stevens, who says, it ain't over. Palmer says, I know it ain't over, but still appeals to the fans. We actually have his back in this one. And Palmer, we're just going to keep him on the outside, I'm assuming. Eat some barricade, Ace Stevens. Oh, and just gets thrown to the floor. It eats another knee. Oh, God. Good night, Evelyn. This might be it. And that's it. We have a new international champion. And finally, Cade once again has someone to share gold with. Ace Stevens, very game. I think he's too confident in this one. The problem is it went to the outside where the brutal Brit just took over. There's that sit-out powerbomb he's been using lately. I don't even know what to call that. That's just brutality. And good night, Evelyn. I don't know why he calls it that. Doesn't even matter. Your winner and your new international champion. Putting a huge plot hole into Scars and Stripes. Travis Palmer proving us all wrong. You know what? Congrats, fella. You came out and you proved yourself. Now, this may be the rematch of the year in Supernova Pro. Brandon Gates immediately ordered a rematch for what he called his television championship against Adam Robinson, who surprised him earlier this week and captured that television championship, which, by the way, it's still marked up in Gates' Project Mayhem strap. So maybe it is just actually his belt. Maybe he's just fighting to get his belt back. He doesn't really care about being the champ. He just wants the belt. That would be hilarious. But Angie Moto, here's what you're missing on Twitch. Moto said no. Nasty Nick said yes. They actually had a match to determine if this match would happen. Nasty Nick came out on top. Yes, our founders had a match. So here we go. Here's the rematch under the same 2 out of 3 falls count anywhere rules as the last match. And we're in Canada. We're in Niagara Falls. And Adam Robinson's from Vancouver, but I'm sure he's still going to have the home country advantage in this one. Is Logo still here? That's the question. I ask myself this question quite often. Oh, there she is. This match is a 2 out of 3 falls championship match. TV title on the line. You're about to see something I haven't seen in quite some time. Smoke, yes, you've seen. Project Mayhem logo, yes, you've seen. But what you haven't seen in a good hot minute is Brandon Gates. First of all, as a challenger in anything. And second of all, Brandon Gates without the television championship. A stronghold on it since he won it unrestricted. Lost it on a show many thought would be just a throwaway show. Looks absolutely just nut sauce without a belt as the Iceman is in our feed. Just Ron Simmons us. That's cool. Shout out to the Iceman. Had a rough go about it this year, but it's good to see him in the feed giving us a shout. And here comes the television champ, but for how long? Matt Robinson. Getting some of those skeevy pyrotechnics. The veteran from Vancouver, British Columbia, our current world television champion. Might not be after this one. Really really cool to see the Amazing One. I figured AR would do something with that strap. Has not made any changes to the belt just yet. And I wouldn't. Here's a challenger. 218 pounds. Grand champ Brandon Gates. Failing it. Not a lot of hysteria, just a lot. No fanfare, just focus. And your champion, 226. Vancouver, British Columbia. Amazing. Adam Robinson. And looks at the belt in disgust. Hands it over. Dash Cunning. Dash Cunning says, "Hey, Brandon, remember this?" "Yeah, okay." Throws it up in the air. Gates. Robinson. This is the rematch, and it is a go. Brandon Gates throwing the mitts early. Paws, hooves, beans, greens, potatoes, tomatoes, snap suplex. Brandon Gates already on the outside. This match is probably going to stay on the outside. Oh, we got weapons. Brandon Gates had a bat right underneath the apron. Intentious in a very disrespectful move. Gets clocked with his own bat, and Adam Robinson just throws it right on to Brandon Gates. Swinging neck breaker followed by that knee to the top of the head from the amazing Adam Robinson. And we're back to the bat work. Adam Robinson trying not to get paid by the hour. Still trying to figure out whether he wants to do this straight up or whether he wants to just beat Brandon Gates to death. I don't think he wants to actually beat Brandon Gates to death. That is homicide. Enforceable in Canada and many other parts of the world. Dash Cunning coming from across the street again. Gives Adam Robinson a one count. Brandon Gates, though, tougher than a $2 steak. Wow. Bicycle kick? Was that a Method of Mayhem knee strike? I'm not sure. But, oh, I was about to say, Brandon Gates has turned this match around. He catches a forearm for all of his troubles. Adam Robinson in full control of this one. To right about now. Sit down powerbomb. Seems to become a staple of Project Mayhem, at least in Supernova Pro. Adam Robinson getting the match back into the ring. Brandon Gates said, "No, we're going back outside. I want to be in the playground as long as I want to be." Brandon Gates, the Pele kick. It's a one count on Adam Robinson. It's been a neckbreaker by Adam Robinson. Now the first fall is so crucial, as you saw in the last match. Elevated elbow drop. Travis Palmer got that first fall. Ace Stevens could not even begin to. Wait a minute. That's amazing. Ace Stevens could not get himself right after the first fall. Ended up taking two in a row. Brandon Gates almost took an arm. Almost took a fall. He did not take the L yet. Yeah. This is a 2 out of 3 falls match. Canadian uppercut. And nice Northern Lights counter by Brandon Gates. Bridged. And Brandon Gates to Iceman approved. After that, Northern Lights counter. Seems to be back in control of this one. Counters Adam Robinson. Kick out, reverse DDT. And just Brandon Gates right now. I'm just watching in awe as Brandon Gates, after getting mollywopped for like the first 70% of this match, being beaten with that bat, which is still out there next to Dash Cunning. I think they're talking about dinner plans. He's gotten himself right back into this one and made it competitive. Eight, that's amazing. High elevation, reverse DDT. We're going to stay on the outside for this one, folks. Reverse capture suplex. And Brandon Gates, what is he thinking? He will save this. Method of mayhem directly to Adam Robinson's face. Almost got to three. I think if Dash was in way better position for that one, that would have been three. Dash Cunning ran from one of the many casinos in Niagara Falls. Oh, yeah, I forgot. I got to make this count. Be right back. And Brandon Gates back in this one. Oh, ho, ho. He did not forget his bat. Adam Robinson also did not forget the bat. Brandon Gates with the reversal. Now back to putting the hooves on Adam Robinson. Tiger suplex. Why is Dash Cunning so far away? Why is he so out of position? That is now three, maybe four falls that could have been counted if Dash Cunning was just in position. The Spanish in position. No one expects it. Oh, Adam Robinson with a reverse kick out, reverse DDT, reverse. Draw two. Rated R super kick. I have to call it. Fireman's carry gut buster. Almost a three count. Yeah, I don't know what's going on right here. This match can take forever if Dash comes there. Then there's Dash. Just dashing off. Doing dashy things. Dash. There's That's Amazing from Adam Robinson. And here comes Dash Cunning. We got ourselves a fall. Brandon Gates took a fall. Brandon Gates is back up. Brandon Gates with a note breaker. Brett Favre just punched the bat out of Adam Robinson's hand to Brandon Gates. And then just drops Adam Robinson on the barricade. Brandon Gates, no lie, one of the toughest guys I've seen in wrestling, let alone the triad. Robinson in full control of this one. There's a one method of mayhem. There's a second. This is murder in the first right here. They each have a fall. Adam Robinson did not get all of the super kick. Matter of fact, got very little of the super kick. He knows he didn't get enough of it as Brandon Gates sidestepped. Brandon Gates up on his feet. Eat it. Oh, went to do more damage to Adam Robinson and the amazing one. A third, maybe fourth. That's amazing. And that's amazing in itself. There's Dash. And Brandon Gates kicks out. Woo. Woo. I got palpitations. I'm like Tropicana, full of palpitations. Don't use that anymore, please. Don't hold it against me, I haven't slept well. And Brandon Gates violates Wizard Rule. Terrible time to violate Wizard Rule, by the way. Basement drop kick by the amazing one. Not nearly enough as Brandon Gates kicks out once more. Oh, I thought we were going back in the ring. Nope. I don't know why we paid for this ring. Brandon Gates just tossed Adam Robinson into the ring post. Tossed. Literally tossed like a log through. Wow. High elevation. I want to reverse DDT. I'm still tossed. Brandon Gates tossed a man that is bigger than him over his own shoulders into a ring post. Miss Cutter Money. Method of Mayhem. Surprise, Ninja. And the belt comes back home. And order has been restored in Project Mayhem. That's amazing. One of like 17 times Adam Robinson hit it. Every time Adam Robinson had a move, Brandon Gates had a counter for it. Point, counterpoint. Brandon Gates' first method of mayhem just, crumbles Adam Robinson. Done. Brandon Gates took the second fall. Adam Robinson got the first fall. And what a superb match. I wouldn't have expected anything less. Now these men are tied at one apiece and have exchanged the television championship, which comes back home to Project Mayhem. And this coming straight from the desk of Injimoto. They will have a rubber match. It will be a steel cage match. There will be a winner. It will be 2 out of 3 falls. And it will be at Scars and Stripes. And that is it from us here at Supernova Pro. I am the commentator who flaps in the night. I am Chip Stackworth. I am out of breath. I'm going to eat. We are Supernova Pro. You have been awesome. We'll see you soon.